Hey, what's up? It's been a while, huh? Don't worry, I'm still alive, and yes, I'm still making videos. I just needed some time to readjust to this hell world we're living in. A lot of shit happened, and it's pretty hard to get used to the pandemic. Like, every time I go outside, I get this deep feeling of dread in my chest. It's as if I'm doing something really dangerous, which is kinda true, I guess. I mean, my risk of catching the plague is actually not that high, especially if it's outside, and especially if everybody's wearing a mask. But still though, like the other day, I drank a cup of coffee after not drinking for a long ass time. And when the caffeine crash happened, I actually panicked, thinking I might be sick or something, forgetting that, you know, caffeine does that to you. And it's not just me I'm worried about either. Like last week, my parents told me they're visiting their friends, and I was just like, what are you doing? Is it necessary right now? Is it a smart thing to do? And after that, I couldn't sleep for like 2 days straight because I just kept worrying about them. And it sucks. It really, really sucks to live under this thick blanket of anxiety and dread every day. It always feels like something bad is about to happen, but I won't know it until 2 weeks from now. It's really draining. So that's why I had to adjust my headspace, if you will, so I can function at all. I just have to kind of accept it, I guess, and try as best as I can to minimize the risk I'm exposed to. But still, I just want this to be over. And you know what? I can manage my risk of infection. I'm not doing great, but it's not the worst. There are millions of people who are unable to manage their risk because they don't have any choice but to expose themselves to the virus, like poor people, migrant workers, and minorities. For example, most COVID-19 patients in Singapore, Qatar, Kuwait, and many other countries are actually migrant workers being held in dormitories. These migrant workers share a room with up to 20 people, which is why the virus can spread so fast and wide in those places. These are the people that need help the most. I can manage my risk. Well, these people don't have any choice at all. In a sense, I'm pretty lucky. So if you want to help, you can donate to one of those organizations that helps migrant workers. I put one in the description, but you can find more online. So yeah, it's a scary world out there. Pandemic going on, injustice rampant, no one knows what the hell is going on, it's just all so chaotic. But it feels like something is happening, doesn't it? It kind of feels like something is changing. But what is exactly changing or where we're heading, I have no idea. I just hope we're heading towards a better future, but who knows? Alright. Having said all of that, I'm back now. I'll try to come up with more videos after this. Hopefully, I can go back to making one video per month, but I can't make promises. All I can say is that I'll try my best to do that. There are so many more topics I want to cover. The history of money and debt. Why policing sucks ass. Which actually should be the next video, so stay tuned. The relationship between technology, capitalism, fossil fuel, and climate change. Ecologically unequal exchange, and a bunch of other stuff. We'll get to those eventually, hopefully. And I've been thinking about changing the style of my videos, but we'll see, since I have zero artistic skill. Like, literally zero. As in, I have zero understanding and zero intuition for anything artistic. But still, expect more videos from now on. Anyways, Black Lives Matter, trans rights are human rights, all cops are bastards. Subscribe for more and follow me on Twitter.